Hi guys, Lewted Host here with another dank stream. Sorry. Today we're gonna be talking about elephants and what makes them run amok, what doesn't make them run amok, what's best to use against them, and what isn't best to use against them. So, as you know, elephants are very damaging, they're very good at what they are supposed to do. But they have to get in close to be truly effective. If they don't, then they're semi-effective. Elephants are technically more effective than chariots are because chariots can get stuck. And once chariots get stuck, their lower health spells the end for them. And I'm not including the Iceni. Like, the Iceni have their own chariots, which are lightly armored and are very easy to get rid of. You have to know how to, obviously. I'm talking about the eastern chariots, like the ones that Pontus, the Seleucids, and Egypt have. So, anyway, back to elephants. If you don't know, there are really two missiles that can beat them. Besides artillery, because artillery can get rid of them pretty quickly too, but at the same time you have to be careful because you won't always be allowed to bring artillery. So how do you beat them? Well, the obvious answer, if you watch the Rome 2 intro, would be arrows. It's not that, or precursors, it's not that simple, however. And I will show you guys why. So, this person that I watch on YouTube uploaded a video talking about how horse archers are slightly bugged because some horse archers will have flaming shot that can make elephants run amok while some don't. Here is Parthia. I always forget that Parthia has access to elephants. Not Parthia, actually. Parthia has access to elephants, but, you know, it's better to just pick a faction that has an elephant general. Epirus doesn't. Carthage does. And so something was mentioned, you know, that it was a bug. I think patch 17 was supposed to fix it, but it probably did fix it, but not in the way that
forever loyal!
Our orders! Melee cavalry at
anyway,
your command!
So we have
swift and accurate!
Archers, horse mounted archers and foot archers. Both of these are low tier, so it doesn't really
horse
matter.
Horse archers!
But as you can see, eastern archers have more men in it. And therefore can make
missile cavalry at your command.
However, what I want to know,
as you say, melee cavalry. We understand.
Run amok. Make elephants run amok.
Archery. We await your orders. We understand.
Now, if you didn't know before. Flaming shot gives horse archers and foot archers, basically archers in general, a 10 bonus versus calf. Yet, this was, well, it still applies, but this used to be very effective before Emperor Edition, where flaming shot actually did more damage than basic shot. Now only artillery benefits.
Forever loyal!
Missile infantry ready!
Assets! Horse archers!
So if you didn't know, if I were to put flaming shot on these guys, they have 150 range.
Shift
their range
fire!
Oops.
Stop now!
125, and they have the same weapon damage.
Missile cavalry! Forward! Advance at speed!
Horse archers tend to have a hard time making elephants run amok.
Raiders advance!
That they actually bugged. They're supposed to make them run amok.
Forward!
Now I'll show you guys
Raiders!
How I know. So we're gonna try this again, but using foot archers instead.
Orders, my lord!
As so, you ordered!
Get them fire!
Same missile damage as horse archers. But they have more men.
Horse archers!
Halt, men!
Knights!
Advance at speed!
Horse archers!
As you say! What are your orders? Quick march!
Assault! Archers!
At speed! Quick march!
All you need to do is just get these guys in range.
Stop!
Now, they're not running amok, obviously. But after that second volley, all of a sudden they run amok. So, this is very interesting because from what we just saw, like, they ran amok from, like, the first volley. Now, on the YouTube video, when you use a different unit of horse archers, this elephant would run amok instantly. Foot archers are good for making elephants run amok, too, but, yeah, as you can see, they ran amok. So, does this mean that if I were to use two horse archers at the same time, that both of them combined would make them run amok? We're going to find that out right now because I didn't test that out. So we're gonna put both of them on flaming shot because,
as you wish.
Again, flaming shot is what makes them run amok, and I'll explain
Assaults!
Why after.
We understand,
horse archers. The tests, because there's one more missile we can use besides our flaming shot.
riders! Forward! Forever loyal!
Fire! Take down those barbarians! Come!
Advance at speed! Forward!
Assaults! Nay!
Horse archers! Loose! Riders at the double! Advance at
order.
Speed! Swift and accurate! Riders,
our
advance!
Order. Riders, advance!
Horse archers! Get them! Any of them!
Second ball, maybe that was the third. They haven't run amok. They will run amok if you, however, use about 50% of your units.
We await your order.
In my opinion, that's kind of the worst. Obvious that they haven't made them run amok. Now, it should be the exact same thing if you use a different type of horse archer. Let's go with the nomads. Let's bring these three and try again. Now, Scythian Amazonian riders have 150 range, 40 missile damage with their regular arrows. This goes down to 125 range and 16 damage with a 10 bonus versus cav. And they go down to 5 shots per minute, I think.
We'll kill them all! As you say!
No,
we hunger for blood and battle! Riders,
advance!
Quickly now!
We're gonna try again, see if this works. It most likely won't, but it did in the stream, or the, we'll try one first. It worked on the YouTube video, so it could work.
The gods guide our shots!
See, it's bugged in this way that they can make them go run amok, a unit that, like this, I don't think they cost the same as tip horse archers, but they probably cost like a bit more. They can make elephants run amok in one volley, which gives us the conclusion that it's bugged. Like, I don't think certain horse archers... I don't think most horse archers have the bonus versus cav for elephants. Either that or it's bugged. But when I looked at the online database, every horse archer unit with 40 missile damage has the same arrow. And every horse archer that has 35 missile damage has the same arrows too. So this gives us the conclusion that it's bugged and CA didn't fix it, or probably doesn't even know that it exists. Now, what about the step horse archers? Because they have 40 missile damage too, and it goes down. Oh yeah, so if you ever go up against a faction that can bring elephants, and they end up bringing elephants, just bring a Scythian Amazonian rider and watch the elephants run amok.
Missile riders! Aye! Gotcha! Step up, archers!
Forward!
Missile on, riders!
So these guys have 5 shots per minute.
Quickly now!
And I think that when you go into flaming shot, you should stay at your original range, but because with heavy shot, all units will go down to 110, and that's something I'm fine with, but with flaming shot, it's a bit different.
Our aim is true!
First of all, you need to
step archers!
Raiders, advance! On me! Advance at speed!
So I think they have the same problems that horse archers have, in which they can't make them run.
Forward!
Just like that.
Raiders, advance! Follow me! Now, riders, forward!
So right now, the only horse archer unit that can make them run amok are the Scythian Amazonian riders. What if we go to Royal Scythia and switch over to their Scythian noblewomen, not their 2 cav units.
Horses love blood.
We hunger for blood and battle.
If they can batter us.
Quickly now!
Now, just bear in mind that they do have precision shot, but
our aim is true.
It only increases up by 3, so not a big deal. On the first volley again, they make them run amok. So again, I think it's bugged in the fact that a unit has to have 150 range. However, for foot archers, we haven't tried a unit that has 125 range, so we don't know whether or not it's just something that all horse archers have, or all units that have 125 range have, or if it's just the cav that have 150 range. So now we're going to try to get a foot archer unit that has 125. Let's start with archers. They're very basic. Basic low tier unit. They have 125 range, 35 weapon, 35 missile damage. Work well with pikes for sure.
Archers! Give them fire! Missiles are waiting to
command us! As you command! By your command!
So this does confirm that it's not the fact that it, whether it's 125 range or 150, because either one will make them run amok. In a battle situation, this is probably not what's going to happen. There might be more archers, there might be, the elephants might be moving around a bit more. Who knows? No matter how many slingers you bring, and no matter how many slingers you focus fire on an elephant, it won't make them run amok. It's possible that it could kill them over time, but they won't run amok. Now keep in mind that only missiles can make elephants run amok. And so now we're going to go into something else, javelin men. Just like air archers, javelin men have a bonus versus cav, depending on what their missile damage is. And I did mention this in a previous stream way back. Javelin men, like these basic javelin men, or even Iberian swordsmen, who carry the Saliferum, they have 29 missile damage and a bonus of 5 versus cavalry. Your basic precursors or units such as Peltas have 32 missile damage with a bonus of 10 versus cavalry.
Missile infantry ready.
Has the same bonus versus cav.
Yours to command.
Less armor piercing.
By your command.
And of course, your 41 missile damage units also have a 10 bonus.
Javelin men. Missiles ready and waiting. General, as you command.
Now, javelin men have to get dangerously close to elephants, and so this isn't always what's going to end up happening. However, historically, javelin men were more of an anti-elephant rule. Like, that's what they had. Like, the Thurios spears were also on the flanks to protect the pikemen from cavalry, from peltasts, and most importantly, elephants. I don't think they mentioned chariots that much, but it's probably for chariots too. Instantly run amok. As you probably have noted, elephants don't really have a missile block chance. They have very high health, but no missile block chance, from what I know. Actually, the tower might be a missile block chance, might give them a missile block chance, so I have to look into that. Because if it does, then it's a missile block chance of 55. No, they don't have a shield. But they do have the tower elephants, which weren't in the game before. Like, they had to reskin them and such. So, they don't have an insult block chance. First of all, it makes them run amok. Something that you might want to take note of. Now, what happens if you make your javelin men use flaming shot? Now, using flaming shot on javelin men is technically useless, but this is just to show you guys what it does. Actually, these guys don't have unit that does. Hell test should, so. Yep. Well, I guess Flaming Shot can be used against, buildings, especially towers. Could be useful for that, but besides that, don't bother to, use Flaming Shot. Don't bother. I mean, I'm gonna show you what it does to elephants, but I still wouldn't recommend it.
Peltas! Give them
orders!
So they have 8 missile damage, which is pretty low. 7 shots per minute, which is the same as regular. As you can see. And peltasts are obviously light, so there are certain battle situations where you can get them on your flanks and then just flank and then threaten elephants.
At the double!
As you can see. However, again, it's pretty pointless. You'd be better off using Standard Shot because it does more damage. I believe Javelins still have that 10 bonus versus Cav. The fact that it's a Flaming Shot doesn't increase it. I could be wrong, but I'll have to check the game files. But yeah, it's pretty pointless. Remember, it does have a bonus versus buildings too, but I don't think elephants are considered buildings, obviously. So, to conclude, flaming arrows on all foot archers work against elephants. Flaming arrows on mounted archers that have 150 range, which are the female archers, will work. 125 ranged horse archers, which are pretty much every male horse archer unit you can think of, will not work cost efficiently. They will work if you use half of your ammunition on the unit, but besides that, it won't work. And so yeah, so most of the times, you will be better off using foot archers to take down or make elephants run amok. While they're running amok, just use regular arrows to hurt them more until they die. With javelins, you don't even need to use Flaming Shot. Just make sure you get a nice volley of either javelins or precursors off. Then, if they run into your spears, they'll tend to get stuck. And then you can just use your spears and your javelins to get rid of them. You have to use combined arms of some sorts to get rid of elephants most cost efficiently. With chariots, it's a little bit trickier because you have to make sure that the chariot gets stuck in a unit that has good mass. They can just go right through anything that's not heavy. Anything that's not heavy, that's not in shield wall. They'll go through hoplites if they're not in hoplite phalanx. They'll almost always go through pikemen if they get them in the flanks or rear. They can go through Romans pretty easily too, but they might like a model or two will get stuck, and that's when the Romans can use their own javelins to get rid of them. So yeah, most of the times use foot archers, flaming arrows to get rid of them. If you have a faction that can use a unit with, sorry, where are they? Glacia. Are you, no, not even Glacia. Let's just use the Nomad faction. A unit that has 150 range, pretty much a female horse archer unit. If you can bring one of them, which only the Nomads can bring, because only the Nomads can bring 150 range units. So if you're playing as the Nomads, make sure that you have these units, because they're good in general, but they're the only horse archers that can efficiently make sure that elephants run amok. With that being said, I just wanted to do a quick land battle. Or if I can, I'll just jump into replays, but I should be able to. Now, I went with the Swebby last time, so I don't want to use them. It's been a while since I've used the Lewted. I wonder if he's here, because sometimes hosts are AFK. Iberian swordsmen could be somewhat useful against Royal Spartans. As always, I bring 4 Tav. As it's the Spartans, I don't need to frenzy charge unless I want to break a unit quickly that's not braced. And like this, an army like this could work. So I don't really need anything else. I'm gonna try to. Yeah. I'll bring one more. And then, yeah. Now that works. Guerrilla warriors are pretty bad against Spartan Hoplites, but if you can get these guys to flank a unit of Spartan Hoplites, that's pretty good. They will win against Spartan Hoplites if they can flank them, but they'll probably take a lot of casualties too, so I have to be careful of that. Of course, the Spartans could just bring like a bunch of pikemen, and that's the end of that. But Spartan pikes are pretty easy to beat with Thorax pikemen. For some reason, sometimes pikemen don't do what they're supposed to. Like, you can have 2 pikes fighting, but then they'll stop because of how Rome 2 pike mechanics work. And then that's just it. Like, you try to do an attack order, all of a sudden they tend to break out of formation. Like, they'll start walking up or running up, and then that's when the other pike unit can beat them. That's why I don't like pike on pike combat in Rome 2. putting the guerrilla warriors there because I don't really know where else to put them.
Armed warriors!
Ready!
Slingers!
Warriors ready!
Valeric Slingers!
Sometimes you don't even get to use all of your Iberian swordsmen's precursors or Durial spears precursors because people tend to rush you before you get a chance. So I'm putting them on the front line so they get that chance.
Lusitani nobles! Ready for battle! Scrappers ready! Lusitani nobles! Ready!
Now, because I want to do this battle really quickly, let's go ahead and start.
Lusitani nobles! Stay together!
Thanks. My army's a bit messed up, but not a big deal, so.
Lusitani nobles!
All my life, I have longed to share a field with the Greek army. To take on their hoplites and test my mind against their generals. They are so beautiful. Let's show them some real barbaric moves.
Battle ready and eager! Run, Tarsu!
Alright, so we just brought a bunch of Spartans, Royal Spartans.
Melee fighters ready!
All it means is that I just have to spend
it again.
Ready! Move it! Warriors, ready! Get the ring!
Iberian sword!
Forward! Melee warriors! Warriors!
Ready!
Move out!
Get running!
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Swords! We'll kill them all! Break off! Scrap them, ready! Iberian cavalry! Charge them down! Veteran shield bearers!
Move it!
One of our units has used all its ammunition. One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Spearman, ready for battle! Our spears are yours! We'll kill them all!
Orders! Ready!
Our men flee the field of battle! This is a shameful display. Unit has perished.
Iberian swords!
Charge! Fire! Warriors eager for blood! Cut the arm!
Ready!
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Iberian swords!
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Veteran shield bearers!
Scutari spearmen! Battle ready and eager! Valyric slingers! Ready! Scutari spearmen!
Iberian swords! Get running! Slinger!
horns!
The battle is turning in our favor.
Warriors, move out! Shield warriors! Shield warriors!
I'll take it. I just want to show you guys one quick replay and then I'm going to end the stream here. It's related to the elephants. So, I was playing as Carthage. I hadn't played as Carthage in a while, so I decided to pick them up and just use them. My opponent, because it was a 2v2, my opponent was Parthia, and he brought a very interesting but very Parthian-like build. With the exception of the elephants, because you don't bring cataphracts and elephants.
As you say!
As you command!
All dressed up! What do they think this is? A party?
I'm not sure if they want to dance or fight!
Let's find out,
shall we?
Ryder, give up now! And spin! Forward!
So I thought this was a very interesting battle because I've never done this. What I'm gonna do. I've never done it before. Carthage is very versatile, but they don't specialize in anything. The only thing they specialize in is. Like, their spear monster is good, but it's not as good as the Greeks. Their melee roster is very diverse, but at the same time, they lack the staying power that the swordsmen have. They are very good infantry killers though, so that's pretty good. Their missiles are diverse, but the Romans are also diverse because they have auxiliaries of what you have. Their melee cav is diverse as well, but they lose to certain factions, notably the successors when it comes to shock cav, because they don't have they only have one unit of shock cav like the Romans. So if you can out-specialize the Carthaginians in something, and then push that advantage, you can beat them. With Parthia, it's Cataphrax. Again, Carthage doesn't have a wide selection of shock cav. And they don't have Cataphrax either. Their noble cav are... did I bring it? Yes, I did. They only have 60 armor. 60 armor is good, but it's not good enough to stop javelins. Over here, my ally was going up against Galatia. One thing I just wanted to point out, Galatian raiders beat raiding horsemen when they are in melee, but raiding horsemen have better shots per minute than Galatian raiders. I don't know if a lot of people knew that. Like, raiding horsemen have less melee attack, less melee defense, and I think the same weapon damage. No, not even the same weapon damage. These Galatian raiders are just better in melee overall, but these guys have better shots per minute. They also have more armor, and I don't know if people knew that either. When I saw this Parthian army, I was kind of taken back because I wasn't expecting a core of Persian hoplites. But when you see the Cataphrax, then that's when you know why he brought that. He was expecting me not to attack him frontally and to just let his slingers kill a lot of my men here, let his Cataphrax charge in, whether it be to my own cav and then follow up with his cav, or frontally into my center, or something else. I don't know what his mindset was. However, I don't just like slingers staying here. The biggest weakness in this army is the center, where his center is only Persian hoplites. Persian hoplites have the same melee defense as Illyrian hoplites. They have less killing power.
Is that not
they're
so,
better for
soldier?
Staying and they're
true,
better for
sir,
supporting
but cavalry men favor shrewd judgment
than they are for
more.
Fighting infantry. Now I did something, if I can fast forward, I did something that was very risky. I brought a general that had the warrior attribute. Now usually you don't bring a general that has the warrior attribute unless you want to use Warcry. I didn't use Warcry this entire battle. I used the second ability, which is Fear. Now, no, not Fear, Intimidate. Fear is the group one. You can get it in both Eight and Attila and this game. Basically, it prevents a unit from using their ability for probably a whole minute. About a whole minute or 30 seconds. Now you're probably wondering, why did I bring that? One battle I fought, or actually no, I watched it. Somebody used Intimidate against a Swebby Ariovistus general, and so the Swebby player couldn't activate Ariovistus, and he got rushed, and he lost. Now the reason why I brought it is because I wasn't sure what he was bringing. In either case, if he had a center of Parthian swordsmen or Persian hoplites, as it is here, in either case, he would have to... He would have to go into shield wall, not shield wall, shield wall or spear hoplite phalanx, to make sure that his units can stay long enough for his cavalry to win over here. So over here I noticed that these Celtic slingers were unsupported. Well, they weren't properly supported, so I decided to help my ally out. And I just charged these Celtic slingers. Also,
understood!
Alright!
Gotcha!
Oi! Took a lot of damage, but they didn't rout, unfortunately. And so yeah, this is how we started off the battle. He decided to focus fire on my Libyan Peltas. I noticed that he was pulling up with his own spearmen, so I decided to pull back.
Fire
tend to not do a lot.
as you say, as you command, as you wish.
Now, Persian Hoplites, an activated intimidate so he couldn't use phalanx. Now, you're going to find out why he did that in a few minutes.
For the people
so obviously, my general's
going to
be because he has 4 years to study.
Kill!
However,
kill!
I decided
kill!
To help.
Another! We understand! As you say!
We're going to go back, so it's fine. Fair enough. Over here, his cavalry are doing nothing. And because of that charge, they drop back and buff all the weapons to try really right in the center. Over here, I decided to go for these Celtic slingers again. So I can put my ally there. So his Palpitation is set to rally, which is what I wanted. Because now, my Celtics can go to the
Celtic
slingers.
Warriors, move out! At speed!
Over here, I bring over my Palpitation to support this cavalry that I thought was going to happen. Because I went on this flank and then went on this flank, I decided to push up.
And the double!
I wanted to take out the
charge!
As possible, so I brought this guitar.
We're not running!
No!
With you, target! Engage! Advance at speed!
So all of a sudden, he has a bunch of units.
Forward,
and this is the biggest
warriors of
he made in the battle. He decides to charge his elephants into my Libyan peltasts. Obviously, as you saw in the test that I was doing, this is a big mistake. I basically created an opening in the center just so I can get to these Indian war elephants in the first place. I don't think he knew that. So they get stuck on my cavalry. All of a sudden, you have 3 units of Peltas firing on you.
Understood!
I don't really care because they run
back
regardless of if they go away to my cab or my Peltas. I've already done what I had to do. By this point, he just quit, so that was pretty much the end of it. His elephants got massacred by the amount of javelins I used on him. And so I believed that by this point my job of taking out the elephants was done, so I just went to support or take out the cav unit that was over here. Over here he's obviously going to use this engagement. He did activate trample, but he went into his own cav anyway, so it didn't really make a difference. I used this unit of elephants to get rid of a unit of Peltas to get rid of the elephants, which are now dragging my unit.
Advance!
And by this point, I knew I won, so I just pulled my some of my rain units to go help my ally, who was actually struggling against Glacia, which makes sense. Over here, these guys have cataphract armor, so I used my javelin to take care of them. Basically, by this point, I had already won. My ally started to actually win because I was able to support just in time. Galatian legionaries are good, but they're not all that good. somebody in the wrong way can make you lose. And speaking of which, I haven't used Glacier in a while now, so I'll have to use them. Over here, I go for the general, who is actually firing on my men. Making sure that he's really good to take him out. So the battle can be over and done with quickly.
No shame will come to any man who dies with me!
Which is what I wanted to
see. Take command! You want it!
By this point, I think the general died, so they invited. The Galician general was dead for a while. I can't remember what killed him. But yeah. Basically, that was a very good game. Good plays on my part. Good plays on Holly's part. Actually won us the battle. But the biggest mistake on my opponent's part was obviously the fact that he tried to charge his elephants into my peltasts. Something that is obviously a big no-no, but he ended up doing anyway. Good game to both of them, and I'll hopefully see them again because I've seen them a bunch of times. Anyway guys, thanks so much for watching, and hope you enjoyed the stream. If you did, smash that subscribe or subscribable button. If you don't see it, oh well. Can't do anything about that. Anyway guys, thanks so much for watching, and hopefully I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye guys.